Namaste everyone, happy morning and warm cordial welcome to one and all to this celebration of 6th International Day of Yoga. Yoga at home, yoga with family, a virtual workshop on yoga for better living, organized by National Service Scheme Unit, that is NSS Unit of KLE Societies, S. Nijalingappa College, Rajaji Nagar, Bengaluru. I'm Dr. Pratibha K.S., Coordinator, Department of Biotechnology and NSS Program Officer. It gives me great and immense pleasure to welcome you all to this virtual workshop on Yoga for Better Living. Any occasion needs the divine blessings of the Lord Almighty. Let us seek the grace of Lord. Asatoma Sadgamaya, Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya, Mrityorma Amritangamaya, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Meaning of this sloka, from ignorance lead me to truth, from darkness lead me to light, from death lead me to immortality. Om peace, peace, peace. Today, I'm deeply honored to see you all here. This virtual workshop has been organized in order to share insights of yoga for better living. There was a time when yoga only used to be the path of sadhana of the great sage Muni in the cave of Himalayas. Eras changed and centuries have been passed. Today, yoga has become a part of every human being life. There was a time when people used to do yoga in their own way. Now, the process of yoga has been improved scientifically and is still improving gradually in India and also in other countries. International Day of Yoga has been celebrated annually on 21st June since 2015. The idea of the International Day of Yoga was first proposed by the current Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi ji. Yoga is an invaluable gift of India's ancient tradition. It embodies unity of mind and body, thought and action, restraint and fulfillment, harmony between man and nature, a holistic approach to health and well-being. It is not about exercise, but to discover the sense of oneness with yourself, the world and the nature. By changing our lifestyle and creating consciousness, it can help in well-being. Let us walk towards adopting an International Yoga Day on an everyday basis. Yoga ratova, boga ratova, sangha ratova, sangha vihinaha, yasya brahmani ramate chittam, nandati nandati nandateva. Meaning, through yoga or through pleasure, in company or alone, one who keeps his mind on Brahman, that is the source of creation, he enjoys. Dear students, we have amongst us an eminent speaker, Ramesh Jalihalji, to share his views on yoga for better living. Now, I take this opportunity to welcome Ramesh Jalihalji, CEO Varenya Homes Faculty Art of Living, who accepted our request to conduct virtual workshop on yoga for better living. Thank you, sir, for gracing this 6th International Day of Yoga with the theme Yoga at Home, Yoga with Family. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Dear students, we always keep coming to you with wonderful opportunity to make you competent at global level. Now, I'm really, really glad to introduce today's invited guest speaker, Ramesh Jalihalji. Ramesh Jalihalji is from educational background with engineering in civil from PDA College of Engineering, Kalburgi. He passed out with third rank to the university in the year 1985. He worked as a professional civil engineer employed in India and abroad till 1997. From 1997, Ramesh ji ran his own business like property development, consultancy, controlling works till date. In his lifetime, he has developed more than 7 lakh square feet of area. Now coming to his yoga background, he has been doing yoga since childhood. He became associated with Art of Living since from the year 2000. Ramesh ji, practicing yoga, pranayama, meditation since then. He has worked in bringing people into the path of yoga and to have celebrate, to have a better living from past 21 years. Especially, he conducts meditation and breath workshops, which enables people to be stress-free, to have clarity of mind, good physical health, and continuous evergreen happiness. The sole aim of today's virtual workshop on yoga for better living, to make self-realization, to overcome all kinds of sufferings, leading to the state of liberation or freedom. With this brief note, I present before you Ramesh Jalihalji to take virtual session on yoga for better living. Jai Hind, Jai Karnataka. Over to Ramesh ji.
Thank you, Pratibha ji. It's so beautiful that, you know, you took so much effort to connect with me, and then, you know, early morning 5 a.m. also you were messaging me, working so much towards the program. I really appreciate your efforts, and I'm very happy that you called me to address the children. So we will go with the flow in four different ways. The first few minutes, we will do what is called as a Sukshma Vyayam, and it's also called as desktop yoga, right? Most of the kids and youth staff, most of the time you spend on sitting on a chair and then working on the laptop and computers. So we will do about 4 or 5 minutes of that. After that, I will talk on yoga for about 6 or 7 minutes, and then we'll do a 15-20 minutes nice stretches of yoga, and then I will take you through a meditation, and then in case if you want to ask me any question, Pratibha ji, I'll be able to answer. Sure. Is that okay with you?
Yes sir, that will be fine. Great.
Thank you so much. So we'll start with the desktop yoga. Sit comfortably and easily. The eyes open. You need not close your eyes. Take your right palm on your head. Yeah. And hold the skull tightly. You should feel the skin of the skull. And start to gently rotate. Yeah. So much of work is done by this head. So we need to give it a nice massage in one direction. Very nice. If you feel any pain anywhere in the head, just observe it. Now we'll take our palm to the back side of the head. Again, gently massage. And then to the sides, temples. Then the forehead, pull it down. It's so relaxing. No? All the time we are using our head so much to work. Just pull it down. And then the temples, give it a nice gentle massage to the temples. If you want, you can keep your eyes closed also when you're doing it and feel the effect of it. Okay. Now for the eyebrows, so much the eyes keep working. Nice massage to the eyebrows. And the underside of the eyes. Just pull it. Yeah. Below the eyeballs. And along where the tears flow, when you cry, the tears flow in this direction. Give a nice massage there. And then your face. And then we have the jaw bones joint here. Give a nice massage there. You will feel a little pain there. If you have stress, you'll feel a little pain there. Give it a nice massage. Very nice, yeah. Then make your fingers like this and along the jawline, pull it down nicely, particularly behind the ears. Yeah, where all the stresses are accumulated. and then the throat. Now the ears. It is said if you pull your ears, then nobody will pull your ears. Yeah? ನಮ್ ಕಿವಿಯನ್ನ ನಾವೇ ಅಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ಇನ್ಯಾರು ನಮ್ ಕಿವಿಯನ್ನು ಎಳೆಯಲ್ಲ. ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಡೌನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್, ಅಪ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗಿವ್ ಇಟ್ ಅ ನೈಸ್ ರೊಟೇಷನಲ್ ಮಸಾಜ್ ಅಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್? ಯಾ. ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್. ನೌ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಶೋಲ್ಡರ್ಸ್, ಅಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೌನ್. Opposite direction. And shake your hands. This is the best exercise. Throw all the garbage out. Throw it, throw it, throw it, throw it. Yeah. Little more, little more. Come on, come on. Till it hurts. You can take your hands up to the sides. Throw, 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 throw. And relax. Now we'll do the neck rotation. It has to be done very gently. And when you rotate the neck, if you feel any pain anywhere in the shoulder or the neck region, just observe the pain. Just observe it. Yeah. Breathe in and the goes head back. Breathe out and the head comes in the front. Now gently in the clockwise direction, breathe in for the half round. And breathe out for the half round, very gently. This has to be done very, very, very slowly and gently. Just observe if there is any pain anywhere. Just observe the pain. The moment you start to observe the pain, it disappears. Two more rounds. Now in the opposite direction. And relax. Observe your breath. You may open your eyes. Now we will do the eyeball rotation. Look to the extreme left. Don't move your head. Just move your eyes to the extreme left. Push, push, push the eyeballs to the extreme left. And now to the right. Push it, push it. Again to the left, to the right, left and right. Now up and down. Anti-clockwise. And blink your eyes. Blink, 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 blink. Channa blink padi. Kan padi. And relax. Yeah. This is called as a stop yoga. You can feel there is sudden freshness in the face. Yeah. Feeling light in the head. Okay. So now about yoga, right? What is yoga? It's a Sanskrit word. Yoga generally means union, no, coming together. So union of what? What is it that we have to unite in yoga? As you know, it is not just our body. Our existence is not just our body, but our existence has different levels, different layers to it. Yeah, we generally identify ourselves only with our physical body. But there are 7 layers to our existence. So what are those 7 layers? First is the physical body, which we are all aware. And then breath. We breathe. So that is the second layer of our existence. Then the mind, which we all are aware of, right? Body, breath, mind. And then the intellect, buddhi, what we call buddhi, with which, you know, we are able to tell something is right, something is wrong, this is good, this is bad. So buddhi, intellect. Then the fifth layer is the memory, smriti we call it as, from where we have all our experiences, from where we generate, we download the knowledge. And then the ego. Ego andre ahankara, it's not durahankara, it is ahankara, right? Ego means me, mine, my book, my home, my car, my children, ego. And beyond the sixth layer of ego is actually the self. That is what we call as chetana athwa atma anta kariti. We call it as atma or we call it as chetana. So these are the 7 layers of our existence. So yoga is about bringing all the 7 layers together. Yoga is not just bending the body. It's not just stretching the body. That is one part of it. But when you're doing this yoga, you are keeping your observation on your breath and your mind is with you. Do you say that? Generally, when we are sitting here, our mind is somewhere going here, there, you know. Isn't it, Pratibhaji? It generally happens, right? So we are here and there, but then mind is somewhere, oh, what I kept in the kitchen on the cooker, you know, on the cooking platform, or, oh, did I forget that? So bringing the mind along with you here in the present moment, with all the faculties together and doing it in a meditative state, that is yoga. And the most beautiful part in a yoga is we have to smile. And smile at whom? We smile at our own self. Generally, whatever we do in life, if you see, we do it for others. We do it for husband or wife or children or parents or to the kids in the college, teaching them, training them. But what about doing something for myself? That is the yoga. That is what is yoga. And food, you know, the source of energy also is the most important thing for yoga. If you want a healthy body, other than the yoga, what we spoke about now, also is the quality of, you know, energy, how you get it. So there are 4 sources of energy that are there. The first source of energy is the food. In food, it is food, water, sunlight, all that is covered in food. Aharadalli idanna cover maadi. What kind of food? The human body is made for vegetarian diet. Okay, it's your decision what you want to eat, but then the human body is made for the vegetarian diet. And how much food? The right amount of food before the stomach says, I'm full, you should stop eating. If you eat less, then also it is not right. You won't have energy. If you eat more, you will feel lazy and sleepy. So the right amount of food and adding more raw vegetables, organic food, is the one source of energy. The second source of energy is sleep. We generally don't know about it. We neglect our sleep. Sleep is another great source of energy. You see, if you don't sleep properly for 2 days, you cannot perform. Isn't it? You lose focus. No, mind goes haywire. So the right amount of sleep, it is said 6 to 8 hours of sleep. For some people, it is 6 hours. For some people, it goes up to 8 hours. If you sleep less is a problem. If you oversleep also, you will feel very lazy. Yeah. So the right amount of sleep, this is a second source of energy. The third source of energy and the most important source of energy is our breath. You can go without food for 7 days, 8 days, 10 days, 15 days. Without water for 3 days, 4 days. But without breath, we cannot survive even for 2 minutes. But how much attention do you pay to your breath? Only when we are angry or when we are cold, oh, there is breath. Otherwise, we never pay attention to our breath. And breath has a relationship with your emotion. If you see, when you're angry, your breath is very fast. When you're sad, your breath is very shallow. Right? So by working on your breath, you can actually control your emotions. Yeah? It's a fantastic source of energy, breath. And the most important, the last is a calm, positive and meditative state of mind. You have to keep yourself in that state of mind, no? To be calm, to be composed, yeah? To be happy. And a meditative state of mind. If you see, whenever somebody talks negative, or when you hear something negative, how your energy goes down, you know, energy completely goes down. Yeah? And when you are with positive people, vibrant people, automatically, see, when you are children, you will see automatically how the energy swells, right? There's so much of energy with the children. So that state of mind also is another source of energy. So food, sleep, breath, and a calm, peaceful, and meditative state of mind. Yoga is understanding the whole thing. You know, it's holistic. Our ancestors, our Rishi Munis were not ordinary people. Today, the whole world is following us. Yes? So, it is said, my Guruji, His Holiness Rishi Ravi Shankar, he says, 1/3 of the world today is doing yoga and meditation. Yeah, so it's a very important thing. So this is a brief introduction of yoga. So I strongly recommend that everybody take out 20 minutes of your time every day and do yoga. Don't miss it and don't forget to smile. Yeah, smile is the most important. They say the best makeup that you can make for your face is your smile. Okay? So keep a beautiful smile on the face. So we will do yogasanas now for about 15, 18 minutes and then I'll take you through a guided meditation. All right, Pratibhaji?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Yes. So I'll keep the laptop down so that you can see me doing it. So we'll start with the small shloka. You can hear me, Pratibhaji?
Yes.
Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Tasmai Shri Shri Gurave Namaha. We will start with the swaying of the body.
Sway your body to the left and to the right. Keep on swaying. And with a smile on the face. Yoga should not be done on a floor. You should have a yoga mat or something under always. Swing more. Like Ganesha. And come back to the center. And keep your eyes closed. Then we can still feel the oscillation happening. Just observe. It is very important to pay attention to your breath, and the mind should be with your body here. Now, turn to the left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, and come back to the center and relax. Between every yoga posture, there should be 2 to 3 rounds of nice deep breaths. Now we will come on over knees and palms for what we call as the cat and dog stretch. This is extremely good for lower back and neck pains. As you breathe in slowly, take your tailbone and head up. And keep breathing. Gently keep on breathing. Now as you breathe out, raise your back, let your chin touch your chest, pull your tummy inside and keep breathing. Pull your stomach inside. Again as you breathe in, your head and tailbone goes up. Observe if there's any pain anywhere. Just observe the pain. And as you breathe out, once again come inside. Your chin is touching your chest. Squeeze your stomach inside. And keep breathing. Then as you breathe out, slowly spread your knees a little apart and come to the child pose. We call it as a child pose. Rest your buttocks behind between your two legs and stretch outside and your forehead and the nose on the floor. And keep breathing. Now as you breathe in, slowly come up. And the posture we are sitting now is called as Vajrasana. It's a perfect posture to sit. Because when you sit in this posture, your back is completely straight. Particularly after food, if you can sit in Vajrasana for 5 minutes, all the gases will escape. Yeah, and the digestion will be proper. Don't forget to smile. And as you breathe in, come on your palms and your feet. The back goes up like an inverted V. Squeeze your stomach inside. As you breathe in, bring your left leg forward between the two palms, head is straight, and keep breathing. As you breathe out, bring the other foot together. If you want, you can bend your knees a little bit and try and hold your fingers and push your head inside and keep breathing. Now very slowly and gently, as you breathe in, come up. Very slowly. And relax. Now we will do two rounds of sun salutations, or what we call as Surya Namaskars. Yeah? Just follow my instructions. Namaste posture. As you breathe in, your hands go back, stretch. As you breathe out, gently come down. As you breathe in, right leg back. As you breathe out, the left leg back, in a perfect plank position. Yeah. As you breathe into the child pose, breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out for Ashtanga Yoga. Your knees, chest, nose, palms are on the floor. As you breathe in, go up. As you breathe out, come inside. As you breathe in, right leg forward. As you breathe out, left leg forward. As you breathe in, hands go back. And as you breathe out, relax. Now we'll do on the other side. Namaste. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in, left leg backwards. Breathe out, right leg backwards. Breathe out to the child pose. Breathe in and breathe out, flat on the floor. Breathe in, head goes backwards. Breathe out, come in. Breathe in, left leg forward. Breathe out, right leg together. Breathe in and breathe out. It's called Surya Namaskara.
Rameshji, we have 3 more minutes. Actually, I'm even here recurring, but we have another 3 more minutes.
Okay. Can you repeat again? What did you say?
Rameshji, we have only 3 minutes in this meeting.
Oh, okay, fine. In this meeting, is it?
Yes, three more. Okay.
All right, yeah. So we'll slowly come down. and sit. And close your eyes. Yeah, and observe your breathing. It's very important after yoga, we rest properly. Keep your eyes closed. And you may gently open your eyes. Yeah. Because of the shortage of time, we couldn't do much. But I would request Pratibhaji, once we are out of the COVID situation, maybe, you know, you can call me to your college and, yeah, I can address the children. It is better to do some kind of a guided meditation after yoga, if you can. Otherwise, rest well, and then you can get back to your normal activity. And thank you, Pratibhaji.
Thank you
for giving me this time and opportunity. I feel blessed to be here and to, I know, contribute whatever little bit I know about it. Yeah, there's so much to learn, but I have my limited knowledge. So whatever I knew, I shared. Okay. Thank you,
Ramesh ji, for spending your valuable time. And that was really a powerful, complete package of yoga for better living. And being a senior most, you are doing our youngsters, young mind, energetic, enthusiastic mind. They must do definitely your role model to those students. On behalf of KLE Society's S. Nizhalingappa College, I thank Ramesh Jali Halji, CEO, Varanya Homes, Faculty, Art of Living, for accepting our invitation and who shared his in-depth knowledge about yoga and Surya Namaskar. Thank you, sir, for joining us. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless you all. Take care of you, sir. Be safe.
Once again, a big thanks to you, sir. Finally, extend my sincere thanks and gratitude to all the participants on behalf of KLE management, principal, heads of various departments and faculty. When you focus problem, you lose the goal. When you focus on your goal, you lose your problem. I, Dr. Pratibha K.S., signing off for today. Stay tuned with me. We'll be back soon with more life-changing programs. Stay safe, protect yourself, protect others.